this is agent Alex Poe. So you want to write a screenplay or a book, but you're not sure about what kind of genre you want it to be. Well, in this video, we're going to discuss the basic main film genres that you can apply to the book you want to write. And we're going to lightly touch on the subgenres, which are hundreds of them. So that's why we're going to talk about it real fast. So I'm going to give you two tips right off the bat. First, I suggest picking a genre that you like and also that you already are familiar with, because when you sit down and write it, you will be more enthusiastic because you like it and because you're more familiar with it. You will know what you're writing about. For example, my first screenplay I ever wrote, I knew I wanted it to be a horror movie because I love horror ever since I was a little kid. And technically, I did make it a drama, like, you know, having a bunch of teenagers and whatever their problems are amongst themselves. And I threw in a horror element, and I specifically made it a subgenre of a slasher film, because my favorite horror movies are slashers. So I just made it a teen drama when I threw in a slasher element of horror. So that's what I would suggest doing right off the bat. Pick something you like and you already know. The first genre we're going to talk about is action. So this is the definition. It includes high energy, big budget, physical stunts, chases with rescues, battles, fights, escapes, destructive crisis, floods, explosions, natural disasters, fires, non-stop motion, spectacular rhythm and pacing, and adventurous, often two-dimensional, good guy heroes battling bad guys, all designed for pure audience escapism. The protagonist usually takes a risky turn, which leads to desperate situations. And here are a couple of examples of action movies. The Expendables, you got John Wick 2, Mad Max Fury Road, and Hardcore Henry, which is literally non-stop pure action. The next genre is adventure. Definition is exciting stories with new experiences or exotic locations. They can include traditional swashbucklers or pirate films, searches or expeditions for lost continents, jungle and desert epics, treasure hunts, disaster films, or searches for the unknown, about a protagonist who journeys to epic or distant places to accomplish something. It has a mission and faces obstacles to get to their destination. Also includes unknown settings and characters with prized properties or features. A couple of examples are Pirates of the Caribbean, Journey to the Center of the Earth, Lord of the Rings, and Maleficent. Now let's talk about the genre, drama. It's a serious, plot-driven presentations portraying realistic character settings, life situations, and stories involving intense character development and interaction, usually not focused on special effects, comedy, or action. A genre of narrative fiction or semi-fiction intended to be more serious than humorous in tone, focusing on in-depth development of realistic characters who must deal with realistic emotional struggles. Some good examples of just pure drama and literally no action in this film is Glengarry Glen Ross. It's just a bunch of talking back and forth, and literally there's no special effects or action that happens. You got Shawshank Redemption, which is a prison drama. Or you can do a sports drama, which is Rocky. Yes, there's boxing and stuff, but it's mainly about the characters. Or you could do Taxi Driver, which is very dark, and yes, there's action and blood and all that, but it's usually focused on one person, and these type of dramas are called character studies. So maybe you could try that one for your first screenplay or book. Another popular genre is crime and gangster. And the definition is crime gangster films are developed around the sinister actions of criminals or mobsters, particularly bank robbers, underworld figures, or ruthless hoodlums who operate outside the law, stealing and murdering their way through life. The criminals or gangsters are often counteracted by a detective protagonist with a whodunit plot. It's about a crime that is being committed or was committed. It can also be an account of a criminal's life. Some examples, one of the best crime gangster films of all time is The Godfather. You also got The Departed. Goodfellas is one of my favorite. And a real good unexpected like twist film is The Usual Suspects. The next genre I'm going to mention is a big one. It's epics and historical epics. Now, if this is your first screenplay or book, I wouldn't recommend choosing this genre because it's usually epic scale with in-depth character development and all that. So I would choose something smaller scale and simpler, but the definition is includes costume dramas, historical dramas, war films, medieval romps, or period pieces or pictures that often cover a large expanse of time set against a vast panoramic backdrop. Epics take an historical or imagined event, mythic, legendary, or heroic figure, and add an extravagant setting or period, lavish costumes, and accompanying everything with granular and spectacular dramatic scope, high production values, and a sweeping musical score. Some sword and scandal films, biblical epics, or films occurring during antiquity. So, I mean, if this is what you want to try right off the bat, good luck. But some examples are Ben-Hur, Lawrence of Arabia, Gandhi, and King of Kings, which is basically a biblical Jesus story. And now let's talk about my favorite genre, horror genre. The definition is it's designed to frighten and to invoke our hidden worst fears, often in a terrifying, shocking finale, while captivating and entertaining us at the same time in a cathartic experience. To deliberately scare or frighten the audience through suspense, violence, or shock, physical fear, or the mundanely gruesome, or a true supernatural horror story, or the weird tale. Now, there are dozens and dozens of subgenres, and for example, here are some movies with some subgenres. You can do monster movies like Frankenstein, possession movies like The Exorcist, which is one of my favorite horror movies. You could do a slasher film, which is like Halloween, or you could do a zombie movie like Night of the Living Dead. So that's why I chose horror because I liked it from the beginning and I kind of know the rules, especially to a slasher film that you must follow to be considered that type of subgenre. So that's why I chose as my first and second screenplay, the horror genre. A real popular genre of movies is science fiction. The definition is often quasi-scientific, visionary, and imaginative, complete with heroes, aliens, distant planets, impossible quests, improbable settings, fantastic places, great, dark, and shadowy villains, futuristic technology, unknown and unknowable forces, and extraordinary monsters, for example, things or creatures from space, either created by mad scientists or by nuclear havoc. It expresses the potential of technology to destroy humankind, particularly when technology or alien life forms become malevolent. They use scientific understanding to explain the universe that it takes place in. It generally includes or is centered on the presumed effects or ramifications of computers or machines, travel or time travel through space, or alternate universes, alien life forms, genetic engineering, or other such things. The science or technology used may or may not be very thoroughly elaborated on. Stories whose scientific elements are responsibly or reasonably detailed, well researched, and considered to be relatively plausible given current knowledge and technology are often referred to as hard science fiction. Now, some examples of science fiction movies are Aliens, 2001: A Space Odyssey, which is probably the best science fiction movie ever made. You got Interstellar, and also Sunshine, which is a great film you should check out. Now let's check out the war genre and war films. The definition is war, anti-war films acknowledge the horror and the heartbreak of war, letting the actual combat fighting against nations or humankind on land, sea, or in the air provide the primary plot or background for the action of the film. They often take a denunciatory, which means public condemnation of someone or something, approach toward warfare. They may include POW tales, stories of military operations, and training. Now, some examples of war films are Cold Mountain, which takes place in the Civil War. You also got Platoon, which is the Vietnam War. You got Saving Private Ryan, which is my favorite war film, set in World War II. And also The Patriot, which is in the Revolutionary War. Here is a classic genre of movies, Westerns. The definition is a eulogy to the early days of the expansive American frontier. Six guns, heroes, dusty towns and trails, cowboys and Indians. Variations have included Italian spaghetti westerns, epic westerns, comic westerns, westerns with outlaws or marshals as the main characters, revenge westerns, and revisionist westerns. It's also set in the American West between the time of the Civil War and the early 12th century. The setting of a wilderness or uncivilized area. They focus on the adventure of the main character or characters and the contrast between civilizations or society and the untamed wilderness, often featuring the characters working to bring civilization to the wilderness. Stories about lone men facing the frontier. Some examples of Western movies, a classic with Clint Eastwood, The Good, the Bad, and the Ugly. You also have True Grit, 310 to Yuma, and also one of my favorite Westerns is Unforgiven, also with Clint Eastwood. And finally, the last main film genre that you can choose from is comedy. Now, I consider this the hardest of the genres because you're either funny or you're not. And I don't know if you can become funny or learn how to be funny. You either got it or you don't. So basically the definition is, it's a light-hearted plots consistently and deliberately designed to amuse and provoke laughter with one-liners and jokes by exaggerating the situation, the language, action, relationships, and characters, including slapstick, screwball, spoofs, and parodies, romantic comedies, black comedies, also called dark satirical comedy, if that's how you pronounce it. And comedy is a story that tells about a series of funny or comical events intended to make the audience laugh. So if your first screenplay or your book, if this is the one you choose, the genre you choose, be very careful, because like I said, I think it's the hardest. And there's not that many comedies that are really great out there. They're slim pickings. So examples of the movies are Step Brothers, the Naked Gun series. Out of the spoof ones, it's Robin Hood, Men in Tights. I really like that one. And obviously Monty Python and the Holy Grail. So these I consider very funny, but not every comedy book or film out there is funny. So be careful with this one. Here's another tip I'm going to give to you, and it's very important. In choosing the right genre for you, I would recommend only to combine two genres at the most. So you take the main simple movie genre that we discussed, and only, like if you want, add a one subgenre to it. So here are some examples of movies that you can look at. So in the action genre, there's a subgenre called buddy cop movies. So for example, Lethal Weapon is the example. Or for adventure in a subgenre of martial arts, The Last Samurai is a good film. Here's a dark comedy that you should check out, In Bruges. Crime genre and a very popular subgenre is film noir. Now, this one's a little complicated if you're starting off because you have to know the right rules in writing a film noir. So, unless you really do your research, I wouldn't recommend this being your first genre to choose. Some drama movies. This one's mixed with a road trip type subgenre, so Easy Rider. It's a drama with going on a road trip. Here are an epic historical genre mixed with the Roman Empire, The Gladiator. Or there's another example of epic historical mixed with medieval times. It is, what's that movie with Orlando Bloom? Kingdom of Heaven. So that's one with medieval times. The horror genre, you can, like I said, there are dozens of subgenres, but another example is horror with a subgenre of psychological thriller of Silence of the Lambs. That's the best example I can think of. With sci-fi, you don't only have to do alien invasion movies, you could do a western. Now, Cowboys and Aliens is not a very good example of a sci-fi western that is a good movie. It's not really a good movie, but it's a good example, I meant, but not a good movie. A war genre instead of just your straight out like World War II or like World War I or just stuff like that, you could do a war spy combination of subgenre like Bridge of Spies. And finally, a western, you can do a modern western, for example, No Country for Old Men. It's set in present time, but that is absolutely in the old style and characters of a western movie. So check some of these out to give you an example of actual good movies that are don't have too many subgenres crammed into one. And my final tip in picking the best genre of to write your screenplay or book, especially if it's your first time, don't combine multiple genres at once. Do not do it. Here are example, the first three at least, of movies that have multiple genres crammed into one movie and it caused it to not make sense and they suck. So the first one is Abraham Lincoln Vampire Hunter. It was a cool concept, but it was just too many genres crammed into one. So you had a sub genre of a bioepic mixed with action and horror. Also, it was technically a war film because it was going on during the Civil War. So all that together didn't really work out. And I don't think it even did good at the box office. Another example back in the day is the Wild Wild West with Will Smith. Now this one, I mean, it was fun for kids when it first came out, but if you really look at it and break down, it's just too many genres stuck into one. First off, it's a western, and it tried to be a comedy. It has action, it also has sci-fi elements with like robots and stuff, with technology and robotics and all that. It was supposed to be like this big epic adventure, and I think it had also war in there because it was going on during the Civil War. So that was just like a box office mess. And I think Will Smith regretted doing the movie after he lobbied to wanting to be in it, but then after it bombed, he was like, yep, big mistake, shouldn't have did this one. Another example on a smaller scale is Safe Haven. So this one is not that many categories or genres stuffed into one, but it was, I guess, too many. So it was a chick flick, first off, okay, with a sad melodrama. Because it had a story about, abuse and wife beating and all that, and domestic abuse and all that, mixed with, spoiler alert, if you don't know the twist, there's a ghost, a supernatural element, all mixed together. So if the first two, being a chick flick and then just like a melodrama, was just that, it could have worked. But then they stuck in the ghost woman in there, and it just messed it all up. Now, an example of a movie that has multiple genres in it, but it actually is like a masterpiece or is a very good movie, very rare where this happens is Blade Runner. Not the remake, the original. So you had a sci-fi element, which was really a subgenre of like steampunk, and you also it was like a crime drama because you had a detective in there, and then it was also a film noir with actual voiceovers and the rules of a film noir. So all that together, in this case, it's one of the like most iconic movies of all time. Some people, either you love it or you hate it, but I think the consensus now is pretty much is a masterpiece. But this was done by, directed by Ridley Scott, and I'm not sure if he wrote it, but if this is your first screenplay or book and you haven't attempted anything before this, I wouldn't recommend trying to write a movie like this. And if you do try to attempt it, I doubt it's going to be an epic masterpiece on your first try. But hey, you never know. I hope this helped you out so you can make the best decision in picking a film or book genre to start writing. So please like, subscribe, comment below, hit me up on Facebook and Twitter, and please subscribe and hit the notification bell for other cool videos. Until next time, see ya.